So I want to begin with a couple of things. Number one, the best news is that the fire is contained. I think people understand that and can see that with our skies clearing a little bit. But of course, right here in Albuquerque, we can still smell that smoke and that fire smell, and that's what it is. A lot of people are saying, why do I smell fireplace? That's how big this fire was. You can feel that all over town. Now, we want to share a couple of things with you today. Number one, I want to thank our firefighters, as well as our open space folks in the Parks Department and in APD. They did an outstanding job of responding quickly, of containing this. Also want to thank the federal team that was able to add air support. And just tactically want to remind folks, it's a little known fact, except to politicians who have to run for office, the east side of the river that is west of roughly a street called Gobbledone is unincorporated. It's in the county. And so we're BCSO, or Bernalillo County Fire and Albuquerque Fire work together all the time. But I also want to let folks know that area is specifically in the county. So that's also why, you know, why is the county calling us and this and that? And we know that did cause some confusion yesterday. But some of that is just the way our jurisdictions work that a lot of people don't know about. Now, what we want to share with you is a couple of things going forward. As we mentioned, there were about 30 acres. It is contained. There are still, whether it's smoldering or embers or small fires that we're monitoring. So it is by no means finished or done. And that's also why people, at least at this stage, should not be alarmed if they do see an occasional plume of smoke here or there where we're putting out a hot spot. Know that first and foremost, we are all over this fire as a community. And so we've got the resources we need and they're out there in the Bosque. But what we need for the public to do is not be in this area of the Bosque. This is not like a house fire where it's out and we bulldoze it and we move on. Forest fires, especially in the Bosque, take days, sometimes weeks, to actually make it appropriate for use again. And so we just want to remind folks, again, only in this area, and there'll be announcements and notifications about where that is, make it pretty obvious. We do need people to stay out, and that includes this holiday weekend. So this section of the Bosque is going to be closed to the public, and we'll speak more about that. Now, our AFR fire chief is going to be up next, and I just want to emphasize, I'll continue to evaluate and monitor the situation with respect to all closures of city-related properties, and most importantly, listen to the recommendation of Chief Gallegos and, of course, input from his counterparts at the county. Their recommendations have not changed, but that's who really drives those decisions. And so with that, our fire chief, Chief Gallegos.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. So as the mayor did mention, again, all of our determining factors are about public safety and making sure that we do keep the public safe in events like this. Recapping about the events, yesterday there was a Bosque fire that did start approximately 5:45 yesterday, was seen by APD officers that were on the river with their boats. We did respond with multiple units. Last night we had probably roughly in all the changeover, over 100 personnel from all over New Mexico coming in to assist us to make sure that we get a good handle on this fire, which around 12 o'clock last night is when we officially determined that we stopped all progression in all areas of the fire, so and had containment of the fire. At this time right now, we are just doing mop-up operations. Again, if you look in there, everybody knows New Mexico and the type of trees that we have. Those cottonwood trees are very dangerous when they are on fire. They are very hollow, and our crews are working very cautiously to make sure that we maintain their safety. And that's what our main concern is our firefighter safety and making sure that we stop the progression of this fire and make sure it's completely out. As we know, the weather is going to continue to ramp up this weekend. The winds are going to pick up tomorrow and going over the weekend, so we want to make sure that we hit this fire and get all the smoldering embers out as quickly and as safely as possible today. So, and in saying that, again, we're going to be continually operating in this area for the next few days. We need to make sure that the public understands that it's for their safety that we're asking them to stay out of this area, both east and west side of the river, from Montaño to the freeway until further notice, until we advise that it is open again. Again, these trees are still burning. It is still very dangerous in there. We don't want anybody else walking around and getting hurt in this operation. So please follow the direction of that we send out to everybody along all the channels, social media, continue to watch it. Again, I want to make sure and thank that all the firefighters that are out there, again, working extremely hard. Mentioning most of the firefighters, again, AFR, the main responder, again, Bernalillo County is taking over the west side and doing a great job on that side. We have firefighters from the states, from Corrales, from Valencia County, from Rio Rancho, from Kirtland Fire, from Sandoval County, from Cochiti Fire. We got resources from all over the states, which is amazing how we work together to make sure that we keep our community safe. And I thank them for all of their hard work. I'll turn it back over.
I'm gonna add anything or just some questions.
Okay. Okay, yes. So again, the recommendation on closing, again, is making sure that we stay out of the bosque, all the, from Montaño to the freeway, and then both sides, east and west, until further notice. Again, that closure will be continuing, possibly through the weekends, through the Memorial Day weekends. Again, we'll notify if any trails do open up, but right now, for the safety of the public, we're asking you guys to stay out there. Again, making sure that you understand that we do like to keep the bosque open. So other parts of the bosque, we want people to be in the bosque walking around those sections that are open, because those eyes and ears help us with that quick response. Again, the quick notification yesterday is what helped us keep this to only 30 acres. Again, with the weather that's came in yesterday, I'm grateful for all the firefighters' work that it didn't turn into a 100-acre fire or bigger or take any type of structures. That's what we're stopping, and that's what we're making sure that is our primary goal here, is to make sure that we keep it out of the community. So again, thank you again.
Okay, so Tom, we take a couple of questions. I just want to mention specifically for folks who are in the bosque a lot, I think it's called Rio Grande State Park. Just stay tuned on where exactly that closure boundary is. So the fire chief gave in general areas to stay out of, but I do know there are two facilities in there that will work with the folks who run that. So Rio Grande State Park, to be determined. And the other one in there is the Rio Grande Nature
Center.
The Rio Grande Nature Center. Again, stay tuned, but hopefully those specific areas we might be able to keep open. And so we'll follow up with details on that.
Okay. Anybody have any questions?
So in 2003, the city closed several areas of the bosque because of the big fire that happened during that time. Last week, we spoke to you about the fires that happened near a bridge, and that was a different situation with the arsonist. You were pretty clear that the bosque is not closing. What is that like for you now? Can we see closures like we saw in 2003?
Sure, well, we'll start with the chief.
Yeah. Could we see them if we do feel that there is a significant danger to the community because of those areas, then we'll evaluate it at that time. But right now, again, the more eyes we have on the bosque, the better. Again, that is what is a major contributing factor to our quick response, to make sure that we get these fires out before they grow to an extent that is very detrimental to our community. So again, the more eyes we have on the bosque to notify us, the better. The only time that we will close areas of the bosque is in situations like this where we feel it is a danger to the community.
At any point, did you guys feel like it could have been a potential bigger situation where it could have burned more than 30 acres and turned into some of the bosque fires we've seen before?
Initially, with the winds, yes, absolutely. That's why we called in as many resources as possible, and that's why our community answered the call, as in community, as in the state of New Mexico. And we got as many resources here as possible so that we made sure that we got ahead of this fire.
I had some questions with the alert system. I know there were some that were sent out last night. Can we just go through the process of how many were sent out and when they were?
I think if you want it.
Yeah. So the alert system is done through our emergency management system, and it's a text alert system that we are able to geographically identify which phones get that alert system, or we can do the entire city. Again, as we got information with the bosque fire, we wanted to alert everybody to, again, stay away from that area, and then we determined, tried to give updates progressively throughout the nights. Again, those alerts also are very, very, they scare a lot of personnel as well. So we didn't want to put out too many We just wanted to make sure that give you guys the information that you needed to keep us safe and to keep you safe.
I think when it came to the alert system, a lot of people were very confused about it, and I think that had to do with just some people weren't getting it or it was delayed. What are some of the factors that can cause some stuff like that?
Well, with technology, there's always going to be glitches, again, and then it's also human communication as well. So again, it's the way the system is designed is that we can pinpoint a geographical area. So if we just want to do a mile around the boss gate, because that's who it's going to affect, then we'll just do that mile around the boss gate. Or if we want to do, say, this morning where we sent out that's we want everybody to stay away from this specific area in the Bosque because people on tramway could want to be coming down here and do a bike route, but we need to inform them that no, it's closed. So again, it's technology that we're still working with. Our emergency operations department is doing a great job of managing it.
Going back to the causes of fire, can you talk a little bit about that?
So at this time, we're still under investigation, and again, still in the process of mopping up and making sure that it is safe for us to do a full investigation. Our fire investigation team is on scene, and they're trying to walk around and evaluate the area, but at this time, it's still under investigation.
We know, like, we had that arsonist just a few days ago even. Is there any worry that might have been another arsonist, or just simply too soon?
It's just too soon to tell right now. Again, as we get more information, we will advise.
And I know you spoke about closing specific areas of the Bosque because it's a danger to the public. Have there been talks about closing the whole thing, or are we not at that point yet with the high fire?
No. The more eyes we have on the Bosque that is not a danger to the public, we want those eyes on the Bosque. So again, this right now, this is a dangerous area because anybody walking through there, the amount of charred trees that are still up that could be fall dangers, the amount of holes that the fires created, the dozer lines that we've cut, they are a complete danger to the community. So that's why we're shutting down this area of the Bosque. But other areas of the Bosque, again, the more eyes we have on the Bosque, the safer it is because of our quick response of exactly where the fire is. So if we shut down the entire Bosque, again, it's less eyes.
And I know that the airboat patrols have been out. Can you talk to me about how that response helped you guys get here in a timely manner?
Absolutely. So again, we're able to both Bernalillo County and Albuquerque Fire as well as APD have airboats that are able to get to the other side of the river very quickly. They both have, both AFR and Bernalillo counties have pumps on them, so we could pump water and try and again slow the fire down from the river, which again is a great resource. It's very hard to, once you get to that edge of that water, and if the fire spans a long distance, and then you can't get to it. But with those airboats, it makes it possible.
Going back to the evacuation notices, I know there was a lot issued from the county, and then they kind of, like, Bernalillo County Sheriff's Office, and then the emergency management. And I know the mayor spoke about the jurisdiction issues. From AFR's perspective, would you guys issue alerts like that in neighborhoods if there was imminent danger? And then twofold, were any homes in desperate need of being evacuated last night because of this fire? Like, why or why not?
So would we issue those type of warnings? Absolutely. If we felt that the community and any houses around the Bosque were in danger and we needed to evacuate them, we would use the same system that happens with all wildland fires, with ready, set, go. So again, advising them, hey, you're in an area where you need to be ready to possibly evacuate. And then yes, you need to start getting ready. And then no, go, you need to get out of your house. We were not at that point. Again, there was an alert system where there was some communication and some miscommunication and alert that was sent out that gave citizens a very confusing message. Again, we were working with both Bernalillo County and SOs of, you know, whenever that got sent out, and it was just a miscommunication that we wanted to evacuate the Bosque Trail area, not the entire residential Bosque area. So again, that was a miscommunication. Make sure that they sent out another emergency message as quickly as possible saying it's just the Bosque Trail area that we want to evacuate and we need you guys to stay out of it because we do have trucks going up and down the trails. We don't want anybody to get hurt. It's getting dark. There's a lot of smoke in the area, so that's where that came from.
And then was there any homes then in imminent danger then? It just seems like the trail area was the scariest part.
No, there was no homes in imminent danger. There was embers again in the air, and I know that it is a scary situation. Obviously, with everything that's going on in the states, this is a very sensitive topic, especially when it hits so close to home. and we want to make sure that's you know what we need to do, and all the information that we could pass out to you, we'll do it as quickly as possible.
Yeah, so obviously the Bernalillo County Sheriff's Department, the fire department's biggest priority is public safety and making sure we're getting as many people out of harm's way as possible. The Sheriff's Department priority on the east side of the river was to evacuate that section, and there was a miscommunication in the dispatch center of evacuation from Rio Grande Boulevard versus Rio Grande River. And that was the misinterpretation. So kind of the fog of war, things were happening very, very quickly. Fire was moving quickly. And all those components sometimes collide that created a little bit of a confusing message. As soon as we realized it, we were alerted to it, and we asked that it be reversed. That's how it occurred.
We had heard, and I had heard that there was an encampment reported in this area like shortly before this fire broke out. Is that true? And if so, are officials looking into if that had anything to do with this?
I think the fire investigators are doing their part too.
Yeah, at this time, it's still under investigation. We haven't gotten any reports of that. So, but as soon as we have more information from the investigation, we'll share that.
With the miscommunication with the alert system, do we know of any recommendations that you guys are possibly maybe thinking of right now that can maybe help the situation if it were to come further down the line?
Yes, ma'am. Absolutely. With every single event, it's a great opportunity for us to learn and put plans in place so that type of situation does not happen again. Obviously, again, people are very very scared of situations like this, so we want to make sure that we avoid those in the future at all costs.
If anybody has anything else, you can forward your questions to me. So, okay?
Thank you.
Thank you.